Join her on the dance floor for the mother-daughter dance.
Thank you. fornication. For an occasion. First of all, I never, there's so many new faces.
Get hold of your mouth.
So many new faces here tonight, and for me, and my name is Greg. I'm sure knows by now, I'm Leah's father. Beautiful, and she looks just beautiful tonight. Yeah! Saying that, I mean, if I didn't know her, I'd say, hey, wow. but of course I'm biased. But Marusha and I,
my wife
Marusha, sitting here, wanted to take a moment here to personally thank everybody gathered here tonight to celebrate Leah and Martin's wedding and getting together in this ceremony. And I also wanted to thank all those people that couldn't be here but wanted to and have shown their appreciation. I wanted to thank Judge Nicholson. I don't know if you're still there, but an incredibly beautiful ceremony. And I don't know if you're mad at the talk, but one of the nicest ceremonies I've ever attended. There are so many other people in this room I need to thank and have appreciated all the wonderful and beautiful things they have done for this whole extended week and beyond of celebration, which is. Yeah, I'm still rattling my head and trying to keep up with it all, to be quite honest with you. But I would also like to personally thank Lucy and John.
Yeah!
Wonderful, wonderful people for accepting Leah, my daughter, into their family as a daughter. Susan and Bridget for accepting Leah as a sister. You have no idea how much this means to us. And also to all the Spickard relatives, and it's endless. And, I still haven't figured it all out yet. I'm trying. But it's, and all of your friends that have just so warmly opened your arms and welcomed Leah into your lives. It's really, there's no words to, you can describe this. It's not a describable thing. But, I wanted to also mention, because I'm trying to read my notes for the time, that Marusha and I, with equal passion, welcome Martin into our family. And so much to us today. And I would also say that includes, as Jennifer Barefoot may have predicted, maybe right, any new additions that may come along in the next 10 years. I put my prediction and I'm still thinking about it. So that's interesting. Further information on you should talk to Chris. But it was interesting last night, I'm trying to get together a speech from a dad, a father. You're looking for ideas, you're researching, what am I going to say, nonsense. And I was fascinated just to sit back and listen to the talks last night. And in particular, I was touched by, I don't know where Susan is, but...
I'm over here.
I was
going to
say.
She's behind you.
Oh, I was particularly touched by your talk and your observations on Martin in his transition, you know, from childhood into the present time, you know, where he has now taken a next really gigantic step forward in his life. I'm thinking, he has just taken a major step into his life to take on the vows of matrimony and marriage with my daughter Leah. And and he's now going to enter a path. And when I analyze that, I'm a physician, a doctor, and analyze things. You know, I look at his principles and values in life and how he perceives life, what he's been brought up with, and how he presents himself, and how my experiences have been with him to date. And I can see, and I'm so much in admiration of that.
Yeah.
And can see that, that together, with Leah's attributes, that they're going to be have an unbeatable combination.
Power couple.
Exactly.
Oh.
Power couple. As they take on life every day, as they take on life's everyday challenges.
Yeah.
This is no joke. When we face life and on a day-to-day basis, so I think this is a wonderful combination. I've seen nothing that would take my mind away from that statement. Weirdly enough, I was touched by John's. Where's John? In the circle of craft this is I was really caught by John's talk last night where he was able to recount the number of days that he was married. I mean, just down to the number. And you know, I'm sitting there thinking, wow. In a very naive way, I sat there pondering about this whole thing, and I said, how the heck did he know that? And how the heck is he keeping track of that? You know, I was having problems just to remember the anniversary date.
Yeah.
And by the way, all you guys out there, the best way to remember your anniversary date is just to forget it one time. You won't forget it again. So, getting back to turning the days, it brought up a lot of memories about my personal relationship and marriage with Marusha, my wife, and the challenges that we dealt with and handled together as life throws all these curves and gifts and constantly at you on a daily, you know, almost a daily basis. And that had a lot of meaning to me in the sense that that we typically, you know, think of anniversaries or an annual review or an annual event, but really actually marriage is a daily event. And it's every day should be like an anniversary in a marriage. And there's so special, unselfish moments that you need to do that show friendship and happiness, subtle symptoms and signs that you show love for one another through small things and thoughts, everyday things that you'll do together. And that you'll be looking out for one another, you'll be caring about each other, and the whole thing. And in my mind, John was clearly right. He was counting the days, because every day was not simply an anniversary, but a dayversary. That's my good term. And, Marisha and I have been together for 12,245 days. I began to realize the importance of a dayversary, how important it is to know one another, and those little idiosyncrasies that we take for granted in our lives. So, on that note, I would like to take a moment to propose a toast. As is the tradition, the father's tradition to do such. And another major, as a goal. So, now, I had to get this page, of course, I had to write this out. To have me and how I feel, and truly from my heart. So, I want to propose a toast to a beautiful coming together, a beautiful match between a ray of sunshine, my daughter.
Yeah, she is.
Yes! Woo! She is!
Someone who is always smiling and whose glass is greater than half full.
Is she mine?
Who not only lights up the room but warms the room up, and a very beautiful woman, and a very beautiful woman tonight.
Yes!
And together with a handsome, energetic, outgoing, down-to-earth, free-spirited man who cares deeply about a lot of people. And I would like to wish that your lives together will be filled with happiness, prosperity, and most importantly, love. Cheers to you both.
Speeches, but how about another big round of applause for Lena's dad on that one? You really know it. Nice job. And at this time, I'd like to invite up our matron of honor, Kat and McDade. Come on up, Kat.
To Eckerd in Florida. I went to Northern Kentucky, and I was just be talking to her on the phone, and she would be, oh, you know, it's in the 80s, sunny down here. Well, I'm at Northern, we're on top of the hill, it's windy and cold, and just, you know, jealous of her, and thought, you know, I should, you know, make some different decisions, or should have made some different decisions. But that's where, you know, I met Leah, and you know, once I got to know Martin, you know, I knew that they were great for each other. You know, they're both kind, outgoing, and adventurous. Yeah, so adventurous. And when I talked to Leah, once we were dating for a while, she said that he was the one, you know, that they wanted to get married. And I was so excited for them, because I could tell that Martin truly makes her happy. You know, just in hanging out and being with them so many times, I could tell. And kind of a quick story, the night of their engagement, us girls were in the bathroom, if you don't know, we go in groups. I don't either, but I have a girl. But she, you know, mentioned that she was ready to get married to Martin the night of the birthday party, to which, you know, we didn't know that he was going to propose that night. So, I just thought that that was, you know, a sweet proposal, that she was saying she was ready, and it happened that night. You know, it just was great, too, because we're surrounded by family and friends, so it just made it even better. And I'm just so excited for you all and what the future holds.
Thank you, Pat.
Yes,
and now we're going to hear from our best man, Hunter Foy. Come on, Hunter. Hello, hello, hello. Alright, just want to start by thanking Martin and Leah's parents. To work for them, we all wouldn't be here together with them.
Yeah!
Our friendship started on the right foot, with Martin aiding me in getting 3 detentions. I walked by him to sharpen my pencil, completely innocent, and he starts flailing his feet around and kicking me. So I decided to steal a shoe. It just so happens one of the grumpiest teachers at Trinity is walking the hall at this point in time, and he rips me out of the room. And I start talking back a little bit, and I went from 1 jug to 3. Needless to say, I was grounded that weekend. So it's a really, really good start to our friendship. These type of shenanigans really are what grew Martin and I's friendship in high school. Playing with technology, trying to get music on our phones. This is pre-iPhone days. That was tough stuff. Yes, we got it. Free things. Being too loud in the halls and throwing pennies at each other's cars on Shelbyville Road driving to school. The only thing louder than Martin saying, "What?" is a penny hitting your car at 50 miles per hour. Martin was known as many in high school as that guy in the purple Jetta. Blue and purple. And it's funny, you think Martin loves school on account of how fast he got there every day. Really have the most memories. Believe it or not, we were making too much noise one evening at Milton House, and the police decided to join our party. Next thing you know, we have 20 college kids hiding on the roof. Now, ladies thick, don't worry, no one got hurt, you're safe, we could be. And the cop starts to walk in the backyard, and Martin's down there talking to him. And he's able to keep the cops back to the roof the whole time. And there's all these kids just sitting on the roof, shh, shh, shh. Martin just talks his cop's ear off, and so he's like, "All right, I'm getting out of here." He leaves, And Martin ended up saving the party by talking too much. She was wonderful. So it's one of your better memories. Fast forward a little bit after Martin fell in love with Leah. And he called me one night and asked what I knew Liz was the right one for me. And then he told me he wanted Leah to move in with him. And I think at that point, he knew he was on the path to marriage at this point. It was an intense conversation. And all I could really say is, no. And I could clearly tell at the end of that conversation, not only did he know, he was absolutely sure of it. I can tell you, Leah, Martin loves you very, very much. You guys are going to have a great life together. Now, if you are going to marry Martin, though, you have to be able to handle an adventure. Because we all know he's going to keep you on your toes for the rest of your life. And I was able to find out and see if she could firsthand. We all took a trip to Belize together. She swam with barracudas, hopped in an old van, and we went across the entire country so we could stay in the middle of the jungle. She swam across a river to explore a giant waterfall in the middle of absolutely nowhere. So, needless to say, she's absolutely able to keep up. You're ready for this. Feel very confident, not only will you be able to handle Martin for the rest of your life, but you'll love his company and energy. Leah, you have passed the front porch test. We can't just picture you going home with Martin, but we picture you going home with us too. We're lucky. We're all here tonight, not just to witness your love, but to say we're here for you. We're here to support both of you guys, for good and bad. You've lived great lives. Everyone can raise your glasses. Now here's to living an even better future together. Let's hear it for the happy couple.
Face to face in this trashy bar, another glass and I am going places. Makes me laugh above the irony of everything. I like the way you're thinking. I don't really care about the music on the dance floor. I don't really mind all the smokers in the bathroom. I don't care at all, baby, you got my attention. So you were saying, oh no, I don't see the logic of things. It's quite a lonely world that we're living in. Oh baby, you are something special, I'm sure. Everything makes total sense when you're next to me. So you were